This week, 48 Hours explores details of the night of the Idaho student murders. Correspondent Peter Van Sant spoke with two of the victims' families, one speaking out for the very first time and one providing new details about their daughter's fight for her life.
It's been a long and painful journey for the families of Kaylee Gonzalez, Madison Mogan, Zanna Kernodal, and Ethan Chapin, the four University of Idaho students who were stabbed to death in the pre-dawn hours of November 13th, 2022.
Do you ever dream of your sister?
Yeah, I've had some dreams of her. Just gives me some peace knowing that I know she's okay.
Zanna Kernodal's sister Jasmine and father Jeffrey are speaking out for the first time since Zanna's murder.
It just happened, you know? What do? You can't do a damn thing.
Everybody's going to work and you look out the window and there's kids running down the street laughing and you're just like, how can you be out there playing? My daughter's dead.
On the night of the murders, Christy and Steve Gonzalez's daughter, Kaylee, was in the same bed as her childhood friend, Maddie Mogan. The Gonzalez's say coroner Kathy Mabbitt told them before a gag order, the killer attacked Maddie first, then moved on to Kaylee.
There's evidence to show that she awakened and tried to get out of that situation.
They say she cried out, and her wounds show she fought for her life.
The way the bed was set up is what...
She was trapped.
She was trapped.
Zanna also fought back. According to her father, she had severe defensive wounds.
She went down fighting.
I believe so. It's upsetting to think about.
She was always a very strong person.
A judge has entered a plea of not guilty on Brian Koberger's behalf, but he is not the person the families want us to remember.
He's not important other than what he did and being held accountable. I'll be here to keep reminding people who these victims are.
So Peter is joining us now, and you mentioned it in this piece, but a reminder to everyone that there's a gag order in place. This case got a lot of attention initially. We haven't seen it in the media that much because really, you know, people can't talk, authorities can't talk, but the families can.
Right, the families can, and what the Gonzalez family, who lost their daughter Kaylee, what they do is they share with us facts from their own investigation. They hired their own investigator, but also facts that the coroner and a lead investigator in the case gave them before the gag order was in place. Mm-hmm. So we have some new information in the course of this show that is fascinating.
I know you don't want to talk about everything you learned, but what's something that sort of jumped out at you?
The big thing is that based on all that they have learned, the Gonzalez family is convinced that Brian Koberger, the suspect in these four killings, entered that house on King Road in Moscow, Idaho, on a day prior to the murders. Mm. Why do they think that? Because the coroner told them that they believe that the two girls on the third floor were the first ones attacked and killed. Mm-hmm. How did he know to go to the third floor? And they also have, the family believes they have found a connection through an Instagram account that they downloaded at the time when Koberger's name first came out. Mm-hmm. And based on their investigation, there's a lot of controversy about this because we haven't been able to get verification from any authority on this. Mm-hmm. But they believe that there is a link that Brian Koberger had liked some pictures of Maddie Mogan, the girl who was in the bed with Kaylee, best friends. They'd been sleeping together since they were little girls.
Right.
And that creates a link. The defense has said there is no link, but the Gonzalez family believes they found
it. It would explain a lot of the questions that people had about, you know, where did he come from? Because it really did seem like there's no way they could possibly sort of cross paths. You do have some good news, though.
There is some good news for the family. Olivia, who is Kaylee's older sister, recently gave birth to a new baby girl in Los Angeles, named Theodora Maddie Kay. The Maddie Kay is for the two best friends who were murdered that day. Mm-hmm. And
oh
the family
gosh,
looks at the
adorable.
Circumstances of this birth as a sign. Olivia looked out and she lives in West LA and she saw a rainbow for the first time while she was in labor. The room she was in was 11:13. That's the date of the murder. And the time that the baby was born was 4:21 a.m. And authorities believe that's when the murders were occurring.
Whoa.
And so the family believes this is a sign from the two girls saying, we're okay.
Whoa, you're giving me chills, Peter. That's incredible. I was lucky enough to get a little bit of a sneak peek this episode. It's really good, really
so
moving.
Powerful.
The families are amazing. Peter Van Sant, thank you so much.
Thank you.
So The Night of the Idaho Student Murders streams Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern right here on CBS News.